We was all at my place that night. Jackie Tarantino, Joe the Jaw, and of course, Art Vandelay. And me, I'm Pete the Meat.
Okay, Blanche, I know you didn't just bring us out here just to dip the bill. What's the deal here? What's the rumble, G?
Here's the game, boys. We need some kale, some Azuma, some dough. What we need is a major heist to put us back on the map. Any ideas, gang?
The First National.
No, you boobs! You wanna get chilled off? We ain't gonna do no can house and no bank job. We need something major. You know, the heist of the decade.
There's a place down Main. You know the place. How about that, boys?
Nah, too risky. They've been guarding that place like it ain't nobody's business since Juba Jeebus tried to knock that place off.
How about the music?
Jim the Swinger Bistler's my name. Knockover's my game. I'd like to join your little, operation.
Beat the Meat!
How you doing?
Listen, Swinger. We're in a bind, see? The family and I can't decide where our next knockout's gonna be. We want it big. We want it easy. You game?
Why,
sure. Alright, kid. What's the plan? Any ideas?
5 words, Beef Biscuit. Chicago Institute of Contemporary Arts. Thousands of priceless paintings, musical recordings, novels from the past decade. Any rich sucker will pay millions for the stash we can steal.
Intriguing, Swinger. What do you say, boys?
I don't know. It doesn't seem right.
Sure.
This kid's good. He's got some definite potential.
Dick Tracy's like a pair of blazing headlights, giving a sliver of visibility in the middle of a snowstorm, with snowflakes falling like ashes from a post-apocalyptic sky. In these times of poverty and depression, it's easy to see why so many people would turn to the life of crime. It's like moths and other smallish insects drawn to a flame. My name is Dick Payne. But they call me the Wolf, because I really know how to sniff out and hunt down bad guys, like a wolf hunting a caribou, or maybe a small moose. I was tempted by the life of crime myself once, when times were really tough. It would have been so easy to do it. Instead, I got the next best job. I'm a cop. That's the chief. He just moved in from down south somewhere.
Hey, that pain. What you reading? Another Dick Tracy comic? About that Beef the Meat fella or whatever the hell his name is.
Ben!
You mean Pete the Meat?
Yeah, Phil.
He's the Bunsen burner, my magnesium, the match to my lighter fluid, the Girl Scouts to my Boy Scout, the fire to my wood. The guy really burns me up, Chief.
Why you out there catching him?
Going out and looking for him now would be pointless. Pointless is number 2 pencil used on way too many Scantron tests without being resharpened.
Yep. Man, you suck at singers, man.
That was cruel. Cruel as a 13th century English dungeon.
You'll be in a dungeon yourself, son, if you don't find him.
Yep.
As I was picking my Dick Tracy comic back up, something caught me. A party at Pete and Mitt's house.
So anyway,
I'd have to show up. I'd meet this guy.
Oh, I don't know. It'd be really weird looking.
valued now is the simple and the smooth, boys. People of our time don't want nothing to be too complex or detailed. They lead simple lives. And they want the resulting culture to reflect that. Major targets are as follows.
You're dirty. This is your brain.
Flash Gordon, the original prince. Flash is an all-American athlete who rises up against Ming the Merciless, the evil dictator of Mongo, and hopes to restore Prince Barin to his rightful throne. Kids like it because in these troubled times of depression, we all want to see a regular guy rise up to the top.
Go.
Popeye the Sailor. Popeye's tough and ugly, but at the same time lovable. He represents the enduring American strength and individualism. Comics all together are appealing to today's readers because of their easily comprehensible pictures and relatively simple plots. Plus, a single strip don't take very long to read, if you know what I mean.
I get you.
Actually, I don't.
Like bullet punch stuff.
Nathaniel is in flesh. Duck Soup. This is a Marx Brothers movie. It's iconic of the precarious position of the identity during the last 10 years. A feat achieved by mirror movements and other stunts taken from silent film. This film is an insult to the rising fascist movements in Europe and across the world. The Thin Man. This film features a detective, a lawyer, a professor, and a hitman, like you, my friend.
Yeah.
And a socialite that are brought together to solve the mystery of a murder that they all had a vested financial interest in.
Sounds good.
This mystery is symbolic of for the search for somebody to blame for this society turned on its head.
Bang.
10.
Did you guys
work till
10
last time?
That was
at
10:30.
The Wizard of Oz, film about a girl taken away by a tornado into a magical land of Oz, represents a common man's dream of escaping, and also the loss of permanence felt by us all during this decade. I've also heard rumor from a PBS special that Wizard of Oz is actually allegory for the political events in the late 1800s, you know, the tornado sweeps away Kansas, representing the populist movement, and takes them all away to follow the yellow brick road of the gold standard with silver shoes. Anyways, I don't know much about that.
Interesting.
You know, I heard that.
I believe you are Ruby.
I believe that's the exact thing that Mrs. Wells said.
No, actually, it's the exact thing that I
yeah,
said.
Yeah, he did bring it up.
Oh, okay then.
And then Mrs. Wells is like, yeah, you're right. This is John Steinbeck. Along with other authors like Farrell, Hemingway, and Lewis, who wrote rather controversial novels that question traditional values. Did you hear that? Controversial. Steinbeck is in particular, wrote books that exposed our many grievous faults and failures, while also showing our dreams of improvement. Along with stories about relatable people and use of everyday language, he is a popular writer. His works contained at the Chicago Institute of Contemporary Arts are highly valued. Other authors to look for are James M. Cain, Raymond